Now let us discuss the topic integers. Now before going to the topic integers, let us revise once again the concept of natural numbers and whole numbers. So what are the numbers which we use to count the things? Naturally we use 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So these numbers are called natural numbers. So the set of natural numbers is denoted by n, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So are these numbers sufficient in our day-to-day life? For example, what should be added to 5 to get 7? So obviously we know that 2. And what should be added to 5 to get the sum 6? So we know that 5 should be added to 1 to get the sum 6. And what should be added to 5 to get the sum again 5? Is there any number in the set of natural numbers to fill the blank? So obviously we cannot find any number. So actually 5 should not be added to any number, means nothing should be added to 5 to get the sum also 5. That nothing is denoted by 0. So then 5 plus 0 equals to 5, or 0 plus 5 equals to 5. So if you include 0 to the set of natural numbers, so we get another set of numbers called whole numbers. So the set of whole numbers denoted by W. So these numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So the natural number together with 0 gives the whole numbers. Here the smallest whole number is 0 and the smallest natural number is 1. Then are these numbers sufficient? Now let us see the different cases. For example, 5 plus dash equals to 0. So what should be added to 5 to get the sum 0? And what should be added to 7 to get the sum 0? So sometime we need to find the measurements like above the sea level and below the sea level. So if above the sea level is denoted by the height above the sea level is represented by positive sign, then below the sea level is represented by the negative sign. And even temperature also we measure like positive temperature and negative temperature, like plus 15 degrees centigrade and minus 15 degrees centigrade. So these numbers are called negative numbers. So here 5 should be added to minus 5 to get the sum 0, and 7 should be added to minus 7 to get the sum 0. So here these numbers are called negative numbers. So if we include negative numbers to the set of whole numbers, then we get again that new number set, that is called integers, the set of integers. So the set of integers z denoted by z or I, so this equals to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus 3 and so on. So in this there are positive numbers, negative numbers together with 0. So the positive numbers are called positive integers and the negative numbers are called negative integers, and 0 is neither positive nor negative. Now let us discuss the set of integers in detail in this topic. Now let us see how to represent the integers on the number line. So first you take a number line. So on this number line, first we mark the integer which is neither positive nor negative, that is 0, and right side to 0 with equal intervals we represent positive integers starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and so on. So this arrow mark represents that there are infinite positive integers right side to 0, and the left side to 0 we represent the negative integers -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7, -8, and so on. So here also the arrow mark represents there are indefinitely many negative integers left side to 0. So then we can write z equals to -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. And here these 1, 2, 3, these are all positive integers, and -1, -2, -3, these are negative integers. And here this 0 is neither positive nor negative. Then when we add positive integer, then we move to the right on the number line. So on the number line, now when we add positive integer, so we move right. So when you add positive integer, we move right side on the number line, and when we add negative integer, so then we move left side on the number line. Now when we subtract positive integer, we move left, and when we subtract negative integer, we move right side on the number line. So these are the different cases to add or subtract positive or negative integers on the number line. Now let us find what is the sum of two positive integers. Means when two positive integers are added, then what is their sum? Now let us check with an example. The sum of two positive integers is always positive integer. Now let's check with an example. For example, 5 is a positive integer and 3 is also a positive integer. Then what is their sum? 5 plus 3 equals to 8. So here 8 is also a positive integer. Then let us take another two positive integers like 4 plus 6. Here 4 and 6 are any two positive integers. Then what is their sum? 4 plus 6 is 10, is also a positive integer. So the sum of any two positive integers is always a positive integer. Means when we add any two positive integers, we again get a positive integer. Now let us see what is the sum of two negative integers. The sum of two negative integers is, now let us see, by taking two negative integers like -5 plus -3. Here -5 and -3 are added. So when you add negative integer, we move left on the number line. So we get -6, -7, -8. So the sum of these two negative integers is again a negative integer, that is -8. And -4 plus of minus 6. So this equals to minus 4 minus 6 is minus 10. So this is also a negative integer. So the sum of any two negative integers is always a negative integer. Now let us see the sum of a positive and a negative integer. The sum of a positive integer and a negative integer. Is. Now let us take an example for this. Let us see it is whether positive integer or negative integer. Minus 5 is negative integer plus 3 is a positive integer. So then we get minus 2 which is negative integer. But when you take minus 4 plus 6, but here in this case we get 2 plus 2. So when you add a positive integer and a negative integer, then we may get a positive integer or a negative integer. Sometimes it may be positive or sometimes it may be negative. So that is why we write the sum of a positive integer and a negative integer is either positive or negative integer. Now let us see how to add the integers without using number line. For example, when the two integers are the same sign, for example 5 plus 3, then 5 plus 3 is 8. So when the two integers are the same sign, then the two integers must be added and we have to put the greater number sign to the result. So if you take minus 5 and minus 3, both negative integers, minus 5 plus half minus 3, here also the two integers have the same sign, that is minus. Then also we should add. So minus 5 minus 3, first without considering the negative sign, first you add the integers like numbers 5 plus 3, 8, and put the same sign as minus 8. For example, minus 7 plus of minus 8 is there. Then here also the two integers have the same sign, that is negative sign. Then here also we must add the two integers without considering the negative sign, that is 7 plus 8, 15, and here the bigger number has minus sign, so here also we put the sign minus 15. And when the two numbers have opposite sign or different sign, like 5 plus of minus 9, here 5 has plus and 9 has minus sign. So the two numbers, the two integers have opposite sign. Then we must do the subtraction. Now without considering the sign, subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. So here 9 minus 5 is 4. And here bigger number 9 has minus sign. So the result also has minus sign. So the result is minus 4. And if minus 16 plus 6 equals 2. So here also one integer has minus sign and the other integer has plus sign. Means the two integers have different sign. So then here we must do the subtraction. Without considering the negative sign, subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. So if you subtract 6 from 16, then we get 10. And here bigger number 16 has minus sign, so the result has minus sign, that is minus 10. Now if you take another example, 15 plus half minus 20. In this case, 15 has plus sign and 20 has minus sign, means the two integers are different signs. Then we must do the subtraction. If two numbers have the same sign, then we must do the addition. If two numbers have the opposite sign, then we must do the subtraction. So in this case, if you subtract the smaller number from the bigger number, when you do not consider the sign minus, then here 20 is a bigger number and 15 is a smaller number. Then subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. So subtract 15 minus from 20, then we get 5. And here bigger number has minus, so minus 5. So 15 plus half minus 20 is minus 5.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.